Good afternoon to the Honorable Chairperson, to the jury members, and to everyone present here. My name is Meenu Hariharan, and I'm doing Masters in Forensic Science from Rashtriya Raksha University. Today, I will be presenting the paper titled Validation of Automatic Voice Comparison Using Likelihood Ratios and Comparison with Traditional Approaches. Forensic voice comparison is an analysis conducted to help the court of law decide who is speaking in an audio recording. Traditional approaches includes auditory approach, where the forensic practitioner listens to the question as well as the known samples and notes down the observation. Then we have the spectrographic approach, where visual inspection of the spectrogram is done. And then we have the acoustic phonetic statistical approach, where measurable acoustic properties of the voice is considered and the statistical analysis of the voice data. We have the automatic approach, where the automatic speaker recognition tries to either identify or recognize a given speaker by processing the speech signals. The aim and objective of the study are, the aim is to validate the automatic voice comparison using likelihood ratios and to compare it with traditional approaches. Likelihood ratios with respect to speaker recognition can be defined as how likely are the features how likely are the features of the QS questioned speaker is produced by the known speaker versus if they had been produced by the random speaker. Then we have the objective of the study, that is to bridge the gap between the two approaches using the likelihood ratio paradigm that is in tune with the requirements of the new paradigm and reports the use of both the traditional acoustic and phonetic automatic methods. Next, we have the softwares used in this study. We have an open source software called Audacity, which was used to convert the speech samples to uncompressed wave format. And then it was also used to truncate the silence in the speech samples. Then we have another open source software that is called eSection, where spectrographic analysis was done using eSection software. And then we have used R software or Microsoft Excel to calculate the likelihood ratios. And then we have used the GMM based automatic voice comparison software for automatic speaker recognition. In the methodology part, throughout the analysis, we have followed the ABRE standards of analysis. And then a transcript was prepared from the questioned speech sample and 20 clearly spoken words were identified from the recording. eSection software was used to extract the format spectra of each pair of the questioned and known words. Then the word pairs with similar intensity and intonation pattern to maximum possible extent was selected from the questioned and reference speech. Then the resonant filter response of the vowel in each word was compared on the eSection software for the matching the resonant frequency peaks. Next, to assess the similarity and typicality of the voice features, a database of the same words was generated from 16 male volunteers after taking their consent. These volunteers were having similar social, economic, and educational background as the suspect. Likelihood ratio was calculated first by ascertaining the intra-speaker variability of the suspect and then the variation in the concatenated speech of the 16 volunteers. The distribution was considered to be normal, and mean and standard deviation of the suspect and the background model was evaluated and calculated. The likelihood ratio was calculated using the denorm function in R software and then normdis function in Microsoft Excel. The automatic speaker comparison software which is a Gaussian mixture model based automatic comparison, where all the 20 words were concatenated, that is, were joined together to make a single file for each speaker. The words were triplicated to meet the requirements of the minimum duration of the record. Each file was then compared with other file, resulting in 17 same speaker comparison. That is, one is the questioned speaker and 16 male volunteers. And then the 272 different speaker comparisons. This resulted in 289 comparison scores. The scores were then converted to likelihood ratios, assuming the score distributions for same speaker and different speakers to be normal with equal variance. Thus, the likelihood ratio was calculated using the given formula, where the numerator is the probability of obtaining the question score given same source hypothesis, and the denominator is the probability of obtaining the question score given different source hypothesis. Then, using the formula in the picture, the log likelihood ratio cost was calculated. Now, in results, 13 words had the three peak form and peak matching. And then we noticed the other words had only two form and peak matching. According to the ABRE standards of reporting, there was a probable identification of the words. Then, when after calculating the likelihood ratio, we found that for format one, there 15 words had greater than one. Then for format two, 17 words had greater than one likelihood ratio. Then format three, 17 words had more than likelihood ratio greater than one. And for format four, likelihood ratio was greater than one for 13 words, which told us that the suspect is the speaker for all these words than any other person in the relevant population. The LR of the suspect was found to be 470, and the CLLR was found to be 0.07, which highlights that it is moderately strong support for the prosecution hypothesis, and CLLR of 0.07 means an excellent validation of the likelihood ratio. The likelihood ratio hypothesis states that if the likelihood ratio is greater than one, then it supports the same speaker hypothesis. If the likelihood ratio is less than one, then it supports the different speaker hypothesis. Thus, from our study, we can say that given the problems with the traditional methods, the likelihood ratio approach combined with the automatic approach is found to be a reasonably correct approach to bridge the gap between the two approaches. But we need to create relevant databases for each case. These are the references which were taken and used. Thank you.